Hi there, and welcome back to the Floss Marketing School. In this video, I'm going to talk about how you can make the Matomo tracking code a lot faster. First of all, I would like to thank Lucas Winkler for all the help that he provided me and all the patience that he offered me. And as well, I would like to know that this video is really kind of experimental because I'm not a developer, neither sysadministrator. There may have some huge mistakes in what I'm saying here, but I'm just going to try to do my best in order to explain you how to make the Matomo tracking code a lot faster. So, in fact, the full video tutorial is made out of this documentation that you can find online explaining how you can make the Matomo JavaScript tracker faster. In fact, here, what they mean by making the Matomo JavaScript tracker faster means several things. It means how you can make this given resources that you can see over here load faster and get time which is reduced, but as well it's about how you can make you can send the data to Matomo faster without taking into consideration that this resource can be loaded faster. So that's the most important thing to note here. Okay, so the first piece of advice that they are giving you is that you need to use cache. By cache, what we mean two things. We mean that the visitor can use his cache. So typically when you refresh the given page, as you can see, I'm just gonna reload it. But, oh, okay, here it disabled cache. But if I activate cache, as you can see, the resources have been loaded quite faster than without cache. So that's the first thing. But in fact, most of your visitors will have actually cache on, so they will benefit actually from this given, let's say, automated features provided by their browser. So here you have nothing to do. So on the other side, what you can do is that you can define your own server in order to have cache enabled. So this only is your system administrator who can set it on, and it means that she or he need to add actually those given line of code within the configuration of your website in order to be able to have cache on and then to make the Matomo tracking code faster. There's another opportunity or advantage that you can take out of Matomo in order to make it load faster by installing this given plugin, which is called the Device Detector Cache. So what it does is that it's looking at one of the most, let's say, intense, or let's say, the part which is processing the more data within the request, which is the one detecting the device of the user and then caching it. So in order to use this feature, what you need to do is that you just need to access to your Matomo. You click here on plugins and then you activate this given plugin, which is called cache, the device detector cache, and that's the only thing that you have to do. You just need to activate it and that's it. It's going to be activated. It provides straight away a significant, about 10% to 20% less in terms of loading time. So if you install this given plugin, you will see it right away, and that actually the loading time of the JavaScript will be at least 10%, 20% less. Then what you can do is that you can ask as well your sysadmin to use what we call gzip. So gzip is the possibility to compress the file on the server. So as a result, when the server will deliver the different files, those files will be compressed. So this is as well something which needs to be installed on the server. So only your sysadmin can handle this part. Most of the time it's activated, but better to check. Then they advise you as well to preload the DNS, though actually this feature won't make the JavaScript load faster, though it will send the data faster. So for example, if you are using a domain name which is different than the one on which you are hosting your website on, then you need to add actually this given line of code. So here you change it to the URL destination where your Matomo is hosted, and you add this within the end of all your pages. Same thing regarding the JavaScript, if it's hosted as well on a different not on a different domain, but if for example you have your Matomo.js tracking code which is inserted in the footer of your page and you would like it to load faster, then you insert this given line of code within the head of your page. Then in order to make as well your Matomo.js load faster, you can use a CDN. So this recommendation is kind of the same for any kind of website if you want them to load faster for some of those resources. Just to let you know, that's not good for privacy because most of CDN are owned by GAFAM or hosted by GAFAM. Then another method consists in fact, delaying the firing of the tracking code by modifying your tracking code, your legacy tracking code, like this or like that. But the two things that you can see here is not going to make the tracking code load faster. It's just going to give the priority to your pages to load, rather than loading the Matomo tracking code. And as well, there is another recommendation that they are making, which is how to merge the JavaScript, which is about merging the JavaScript tracker with other files. For this, that's mostly a plugin that you will install on your CMS in order to sell to your CMS to gather all the JavaScript together and optimize the time. So this one may provide a bit of increase in terms of decrease in terms of loading time. And this one is very interesting, but I already wrote a full article about it, which is about using this given plugin, the Qt tracking. And this one is interesting because it will decrease the loading time of the PHP request. And of course, if you don't want to have any loading script at all, you can use the log import script, and that's the final recommendation that the Matomo team is giving you. And hope actually this video helps you a little bit understand how you can make the Matomo trackers load faster. Thanks for watching.